Modern cars come usually with big AGM batteries, which are not the same as acid lead batteries. The question is, can you replace with acid lead batteries an AGM battery? Which is actually what I did. This is a acid lead battery, it's coming from another brand. And my car had a big AGM battery, which failed after only 3 years and very few miles. And I am using this acid lead battery. It's a group 35, which almost fits. I did have to change the bracket here to secure it properly, but I did use it for about 6 months and it has been doing perfectly fine. I did measure it. It's very nice condition. It didn't fail. It didn't wear at all. So you can use it, but there are a few conditions to be aware of. First off, you need to use a quality acid lead battery. And the reason for this is actually one of the reasons they are putting AGM in newer cars. The AGM stands better to be discharged continuously. And that's what happens is newer cars have different charging systems. When you drive the car, the battery, if it's topped up, the car will drive on the battery alone. It will shut the alternator regulator off. So you'll see a voltage of around 12 and something while driving until the battery drops a little bit, maybe to 97-98%. Then the alternator regulator kicks in to 14 or something like this to top up the battery. Then it drops again to 12. So the battery, it's used more intensively than in older cars. That's why you need to have an acid lead battery that's really quality, not a cheap brand. The second part is when the car has those start stop system, whether with a traffic light or something like this, it's using very intensively the battery. So at that condition, if your car has start stop system and you don't turn it off, you need to have an AGM battery. You cannot replace it with acid lead because the acid lead, it's not used to be used so intensively. Always charge discharge, especially in slow traffic, bumper to bumper, is gonna fail very soon. But the reason I did replace with acid lead, my car does not have stop and start function, is that the AGM did fail very early, like 30,000 miles, 5 years old. And I think one of the reasons is that it is very nearby the engine. AGM battery do not like heat from the engine. Acid lead does not like that either, but it's much resilient. It resists much better heat from the engine when it's located inside the engine bay. That's why I did replace with acid lead. Also, it's cheaper. Internet is saying AGM is lasting longer, but it don't say if it's located nearby the engine, it's not going to last that long. You may notice that the tray for the AGM battery, it's much bigger. The reason is I did replace with the smaller size battery. It's doing just perfectly fine. I think the AGM had something like 600 CCA. This one has 500 CCA, perfectly doing. Just that it has less storage, basically. You just need not to listen too much to your radio when your engine is off. So you can replace to acid lead battery. You need to find one that fits inside the tray. Make sure you secure it properly. You don't want the battery to flip around or move to one side. You have a small crash and may cause a fire or so.